What's up, guys? Today we're going to be checking out a classic DC-esque Marvel movie, 1998's Blade on 4K Blu-ray. This isn't a movie review, I'm just going to share with you some of my thoughts on the video and the audio quality. But before we get into it, if you're into new movies and new home theater equipment, then be sure to tap that subscribe button for new weekly videos. Now let's go over a few tech specs. The movie was shot on 35mm, it's got a 4K DI, it's rated R, runtime is 120 minutes, and the aspect ratio is 239:1, meaning there are black letterbox bars. Now this is a great looking catalog transfer and a sizable upgrade over the regular Blu-ray. First thing you'll notice is how clean and sharp the image is. I'd almost say it's too clean. I do think they've used some very light noise reduction. Certain shots look a bit too smooth, some faces are waxy, and this shot of Frost and his chest hair is kind of smeared over. I'm not talking Terminator 2 levels of waxiness, but you can tell it's just a little too clean. The film grain is almost gone as well. I mean, there is still some very faint grain, but it's very, very light. So if you're a grain hater, you're gonna love the way this movie looks. Now, don't get me wrong, this is still an awesome looking transfer. There's actually a lot of shots that could pass for a movie that was shot today. You'll notice close-ups have very fine detail like pores and strands of hair, and costumes have better textural detail too. The older Blu-ray is much softer in comparison. Although, with all the additional resolution, all that CGI sorta doesn't hold up all that well. I don't think it was ever that great to begin with, but seeing Blade's sword floating out of someone's back as a cartoon does look off. The gooey bloody makeup and physical effects do look great though. Color-wise, it gets a nice boost in the black level department. Blacks reach deeper and elevates the contrast levels, giving the image greater depth and much better pop. Specular highlights can get blindingly bright during the sunrises and towards the end with the electricity. That's probably why Blade wears sunglasses. HDR also punches up whatever primary colors there are, so you do get the occasional splash of vividness. Blade is also a fairly bright looking transfer, unlike movies where the HDR makes the picture appear dim.
Some motherfuckers are always trying to ice skate uphill.
Audio gets a fresh new Dolby Atmos mix, and this one's a winner. The original mix was great back in the day, but this new one just elevates it to another level. The opening scene in the meat locker is still one of the best action moments ever. I've seen this part way too many times. Listening to this in Atmos just makes you want to crank the volume up to max. Taking a look at the object viewer, you can see there are 17 dynamic objects, and they are moving in every direction. The techno beat is clean with a solid low end, and you'll hear the crowd envelop you in all the lower channels. You got gunfire blasting away left and right, and you can now hear Blade's boomerang circle around the room seamlessly. I'm gonna say every time they start playing some techno, you just want to listen at reference levels. Soundstage is bigger and more cinematic coming from the older mix, with nice natural extension up to the height speakers. There's always some ambiance that surrounds the listening area from everywhere. You'll hear very faint mechanical noises in the back speakers when you're in Blade's hideout, and when you're at a party, you'll hear chatter all around you as if you were really there. Now there isn't anything major that happens in the high channels as it's mostly atmospherics that makes the movie more lively, although when the skeletons start flying around at the end, you can hear them zipping around above your head. Bass Response has solid extension down low and hits hard during the big action scenes. I wouldn't say it's reference level, but I doubt you'd find much to complain about. And dialogue is perfectly fine without any issues. So for audio, I'm gonna go with a 9. This is an active mix from start to finish. There's natural extension up to the high channels that doesn't feel forced. It's got awesome bass and an expansive soundstage. And the musical soundtrack is a standout. For video, I'm gonna go 8.8. Aside from the occasional waxiness, the image quality is a big step up from the 1080p version. There's more detail, more sharpness and clarity, better color saturation, and some blinding highlights. If you're a fan of comic book movies that are dark and gritty, then this movie is a must-own. If you've got the older Blu-ray, then you might as well toss that one out and just put this one in its place. It's a worthy upgrade and should already be in your collection. So what are your thoughts on Blade on 4K Blu-ray? Do you think it's a noticeable increase from the older disc? Leave a comment and let us know. Now if you want to grab this movie, I'll leave some links for it down below in the video's description. As always guys, thanks for watching. If you want, you can follow us on social media, and if you want to get exclusive content or great discounts on audio and video gear, then stop by our Patreon page. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and we'll see you guys again in the next video.